Taking you to the final frontier this morning, astronomers have discovered 7 Earth-sized planets orbiting a star. It raises the possibility of life in outer space.
So interesting. And this morning we have a chance to speak live with NASA scientist Dr. Hannah Wakeford about this amazing discovery. And Dr. Wakeford, please tell us more about these exciting results.
Good morning. This is such an exciting result. We have found that there are 7 Earth-sized planets around a star called TRAPPIST-1. Now, these Earth-sized planets actually orbit very close to their star, but they are in the habitable zone. So 3 of these planets you can see on that graphic there, E, F, and G, are in the habitable zone of their star. And that means that if they have a surface, liquid water could exist there. But this is such an alien system, it could fit within the orbit of Mercury if we put it in our own solar system. So imagine 7 Earth-sized planets in between Mercury and the Sun. It's very different from our own, but very exciting.
Yeah, indeed. And these planets are so far away. Are we going to be able to tell if they're similar to our planets in our solar system?
So these planets are actually 40 light years away. So we consider that the solar neighborhood. So this is a neighboring star to us. But what we're able to do is we're able to use our space telescopes to look at the transit of these planets. So as they pass in front of their star, they block out a small amount of light. So it's the equivalent of if you watched a street lamp and a mosquito flew in front of it. But we're able to use our space telescopes, like the Hubble Space Telescope, to look at these planets as they pass in front of the star and see some of the starlight that is shining through that atmosphere. So we can actually get a spectrum of their atmosphere, which is really, really exciting for us.
And Doctor, so much of this sounds like pure science fiction to us. Here in Florida, we focus a lot on Cape Canaveral, you know, the shuttle launches back in the past. But now it seems like NASA may be making a shift to discovering a growing area outside of what was previously done in NASA. What are you guys up to?
Yeah, so NASA is actually launching the TESS Space Telescope, which is actually going to be looking for loads more of these types of exoplanets. So it's going to be looking at our nearby stars that are very, very bright for new exoplanets. And what we're able to do with those exoplanets that are being discovered is follow them up with Hubble and the new James Webb Space Telescope, which will launch in 2018. Now, that will be the largest telescope ever launched into space by NASA. And we're going to be able to get a really, really good view of these worlds and try and learn a little bit more about what's in their atmospheres. So that's really, really exciting for everybody, to be honest. And I would say that we haven't heard the last of this TRAPPIST-1 system yet.
All right. Can't wait to see those exciting images.
Yeah. Fascinating. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us this morning.